Today we're going to cover a special case that's quite common when it comes to cleaning and organizing your data in Excel. Now this question actually originated from LinkedIn, just with different data. What we need to do is to come up with a dynamic way to switch the data in columns to rows. So for example here, I have a column for project, department, and person. I need to switch the department information to become separate headers, so sales, finance, and marketing will be their own columns. And then I have the list of projects on the side here, and the values part will be the content of the person column. The catch is that multiple people from the same department can be working on the same project. How can we show all of this correctly? We're going to take a look at different options. I'm going to show you three. One is going to use formulas, the next one Power Query, and finally DAX. Let me know which one you prefer, or if you have another way of solving this. Let's solve this first with formulas. What I need here is a unique list for the project column. So I'm just going to use the unique function. All it needs is an array, which is the project column. Close bracket, press enter, and I have my unique list or distinct list of values. Better way to call that. For the headers here, I need a unique list for department. So let's go ahead and do that. Select a department column, close bracket, press enter, and my list spells this way. I want it the other way, so I'm just gonna put it inside the transpose function, close the bracket here, and I have my distinct list for department. Okay, so far so good. Now we need to get the correct person that works for this project and for this department. The problem is, sometimes we have more than one person from each department working on the same project. Okay, so how do we handle that? If we just think about a function that can give us multiple results, what would that be? The filter function, right? So let's go with that, because here I can't really use VLOOKUP or XLOOKUP because these functions just return one result. We need something that returns multiple results, and filter works great here. The first argument requires an array. This is the result that I want to get back. Well, I want to get a person back, so I'm going to go with this column. Next is the include argument. Now, this is the tricky part because it needs to look at the combination of project and department so that it can find the right person. This means that my include argument is going to have the combination of project, I'm going to use an ampersand here, and department, and compare this with the combination of this and this. Now let's also plan on how we need to fix this, because I'm planning to copy the formula down and across. Well, here for E3, we don't want the E to shift. We want the 3 to change, right? We want the row to change. So I'm going to press F4 three times to just fix the E. And for F2, I want the 2 to be fixed. I want the row to be fixed, but the column to be variable. The last argument for filter is what it should return if it doesn't find a match, and I'm just going to put quotation quotation, so it returns nothing. Close bracket, press enter, and here I get two results that's spilling down. Well, this is going to give me a problem because the second result should belong to Nightfire, right? And also, when a formula spills, I can't just copy it down because I'm going to get this hash spill error. So this means I need a formula now to combine these two values into a single value. And I can use the text join function here. Text join requires a delimiter. For my delimiter, I'm going to go with a space and space quotation. Next argument is whether empty rows should be ignored or not. Well, let's just go with true. And the last argument is the text that I want to combine. And that's these two values in this case. So let's go all the way to the end. Actually, let's expand this so you can see the full formula. Close the bracket here, press enter, and now we have both names in the same cell. Okay, so let's just expand this as well so we can read it better. We can copy this down and copy this across, but when we come to copy this across, the table references end up moving. That's not something I want. So instead of pulling this across this way, we're going to copy this. So press Control C and then just paste this here. This is going to make sure that your table references don't move. Okay, so now we have the correct persons. Let's just make this bold and this bold so we can see it better. We have Donald and Gary working on the Grand Slam project, Just Holly for Nightfire, and Lucas and Sky from marketing, they're right here, working on the CFire project. Also, Paul from sales is working on CFire. Now, this is fully dynamic. So if for CFire, we have a new person in sales that's going to join. So let's say I join, I'm going to end up here with Paul. Okay, so that was the first method of solving this using formulas. Now let's take a look at the Power Query version. As a first step, let's go to the Data tab and send this to Power Query. So select From Sheet. The logical step here would be to pivot this column, right? Because this is the column that I want to make headers out of. Sales should become a header, finance should become a header, and marketing a header as well. So this means I should pivot this. So let's go ahead and do that. Go to Transform and select Pivot Column. Now I need to select what I want as values. I don't have numbers, I just have text. So my values column is going to become my person because that's what I want to be in the middle here. And under advanced options, I need to adjust this to don't aggregate, right? Because I don't want to count them. I don't want to get the max or min of this text. I want to get the text so I don't need to aggregate anything here. And I'm going to go with okay. This works for cases where I just have one person from a department working on a project, but not where I have multiple people. And the reason is there are too many elements here. It cannot show multiple cells in a single cell. This means that I need to do that combination. I need to bring the different elements into a single cell before I pivot the column, right? So I'm gonna reverse this out. So here, for example, I need to combine Donald and Gary in the same cell. So I just have one line for Grand Slam and sales. Because once I have that, I wouldn't have any problems pivoting the column. So this sounds like grouping. I need to group these two columns together. So I'm going to highlight these and go with group by. It automatically put my selection here. Now for the new column name, let's just leave it as is, but I don't want to do any type of aggregation. I just want to return all the rows and then click on OK. So now I have a unique combination for project and department. And check this out, when I click on the side, I get the multiple records here as a table. For Nightfire here, I just have one person. This is also one person. And then I have two people here from the marketing department working on CFire. Okay, so now I've managed to create one line, but I need to combine these two values into a single cell. I can't just expand this because this is going to put me where I was before. It's going to create a new row. Instead, I need to create a list out of this person column. To do that, I can add a column and add a custom column. I'll just leave the name as is. That custom column is just going to grab the person column from this one here. So notice this column is called count because I didn't change the name. So I'm just going to select that. And now I need to get the person columns. I have to use the column syntax, which is the square brackets. I can't see person here because this only shows me the columns that are visible. This one is like a table in a table. So I just have to type it out, close the square bracket and click on OK. Now I have a list. So when I click to the side, I just have the content of that single column. But what's so great about lists is this. When I click on this double-sided arrow, I get to extract the values. So I don't want to expand to new rows because it's going to put me where I was, but instead I want to extract the values. And when you do that, you get to select your delimiter of your choice. I'm going to go with custom, add a space, ampersand space, and click on OK. And now I'm going to get the multiple values in a single cell. Okay, so I just have to remove this. And let's go and pivot this column. Go to Transform, Pivot Column. My values column here is this custom column now. So let's select that. For advanced options, I want to go with don't aggregate and click on OK. And I have the correct view. Okay, so we're done with this. We can update the name. And let's send this to Excel, home, close and load 2. I'm going to put it right here on the existing sheet so we can compare. Click on OK, and this is our Power Query solution. Let's also test this. I'm going to add Nightfire, Finance, Leila. This one should get automatically updated. Let's check. I'm right there. And this one will get updated after I press refresh. Another way of solving this is with Power Pivot and DAX. Let's take a look at that solution on another sheet. So I've copied the table over. This time I called it T Project 2. Now, first thing we're going to do is send this to the data model. So I'm going to go to the Power Pivot tab and add to data model. This is going to bring up Power Pivot, and I could go ahead and write my measure here, but I'm not going to do that because first I want to create the pivot table, and then we can think about the type of measure that we need. I'll put the pivot table right here. Let's go to the Insert tab, Pivot Table, and I'm going to insert it from the data model. I want it on the existing sheet. Right here is fine. Click on OK. This is T Project 2. What I want to see in the rows here is the project, and I want to have department in the columns. Now, I want to have person in the values, but we know that if I bring person right now to the value section, it's going to convert it to numbers, right? By default, it's going to give count of person. Well, that's not what I want. Instead, I want to go through the table here, or basically the values in the person column, and I want to concatenate them. Because I'm going to be iterating over a table, there is a function I can use here that's called concatenateX. Let's create our measure. I'm just going to right mouse click here and add measure. Call that measure person allocation. The function I need is concatenateX. This function needs a table to iterate over. Well, I could use the entire project table, and let's do that in the first round. So it was called T Project 2. It's right here. Then I need the expression. Well, my expression in this case is what I want returned, which is the person column. So let's go with person here. Then I need the delimiter, and that's going to be in quotations and with the and, space, and close bracket. Okay, so let's make this bigger. That's basically my function. Let's check it. All good. Click on OK. Now let's bring it to the values section. And it works great. I see Alyssa here, Richard here for sales. I have two people, and I automatically get these grand totals. Now I can remove the grand totals from view in this case because it's a small data set, but I'd rather improve on the DAX measure and make the grand totals just not show, right? Because they're irrelevant in this case. But this is what I need to take care of, is that I have grand totals in the rows and in the columns, right, on both sides. I need to suppress them on both sides. Okay, so let's go back to our measure, right mouse click and edit the measure, and let's optimize this. Before I do the concatenation, I'm going to use an if, and I'm going to check whether I'm at a grand total cell or I'm somewhere inside the pivot table. Well, when I'm inside the pivot table, I only have one value here for the project and also one value for the department. But I can't use the function has one value because it's still going to give me grand totals in cases like this one here for Imogen, where I have just one value for the project and one value for the department. The other departments are empty. So this one would still return a grand total. Instead, I have to use another function that's HASONEFILTER, or I can also use isFiltered in this case, but I'll just go with HASONEFILTER. Now, before I do that, I'm checking for two things, right? I have two grand totals. So let's start with an AND function, then use HASONEFILTER. Let's go with the project column first, close bracket, and the second part of my logical test is HASONEFILTER. This time for the department. Now I'm going to close this, so let's organize this a little bit better. I need to close the AND logical test here, so let's close the bracket, press comma. I'm just going to press Shift Enter to break this up. Then for the result, if true, I want my concatenex function. And for result, if false, I want to have a blank. So I'm just going to close this off. Now, another thing I can also improve on is this part here. I don't necessarily need to iterate over the whole table. I can iterate over the values, basically the unique values I have in the person column. So we can also change this to the values function and reference the person column. Okay, so let's just make sure everything is fine. Check DAX formula. It doesn't have errors, and click on OK. And now we get to suppress the grand totals. Now, if we think this through, how this formula works, let's say we're right here. We have a single filter for project and for the department. The filter context here is going to filter our underlying table, which is this one, to only show CFIRE. Okay, so only these lines and only the marketing department. So that will be only this line and this line. The concatenex function is going to go ahead and get the unique values of the person column, which is these two, and then it's going to concatenate them together with an ampersand as the delimiter. Now let's just quickly test this. I'm actually going to add a brand new project. Let's just call new. It's going to be in the finance department, and I'm a part of it. So let's right mouse click and refresh this, and I pop up right here. If all of a sudden I allocated to the Nightfire project, let's just right mouse click here and refresh this, and I should be in here. Okay, so this concludes our Power Pivot version. As you can see in Excel, there is more than one way to solve a problem. Now, your approach might be completely different to mine, and that's fine as long as the answer is what you want. I hope you enjoyed this video. As usual, if you did, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to our community here, do consider subscribing, and I'm going to see you in the next video.